Hello everyone, Christina Werner here. Welcome to another live stream at my YouTube channel. Thanks so much for joining me tonight. And tonight I'm going to be creating and playing with some products from Concord and Ninth. And I do have a little bit of a poll for those who are watching live. I've got two different color combos that I've picked out, and I need all of you in the comments to vote for your favorite combo. So I'm going to set these aside, and here are the combos. We've got combo one. Oh, let's get it actually on screen. There's combo one or combo two. Kind of different looks for each one. So let me get this poll up, and you guys will be able to choose which combo you like to see. One is kind of a little bit more a traditional kind of rainbow. And this other one is, I don't know, it's kind of got a little bit of a retro vibe to it. So whatever you'd like. I have to laugh. Scrappy guy saying I like the black nails. They're technically not black. They're just a really, really dark red. Which is, I mean, if I was out in full sunlight, you could see a little bit of the red to them, but they're very dark. The link to the polished color that I'm wearing is down below. I did put that in before going live. So there's always that. So go ahead and put in all of your combos, whatever you'd like to see, and or your vote for the combos. And I'll do this for just a few more minutes, and then we'll close up and start stamping and all that. So those of you who are putting your votes in the comments, go ahead and use the poll feature. Pretty sure the poll shows up whether you're on a computer or a mobile device, but just in case. I knew I should have written dark nails. That's funny. Too funny. Well, thanks so much for joining me and with my dark nails. Oh, and Jen says her Dazzle Dry arrived today. Excited to try it. I hope you really love it. I've heard from quite a few of you who tried it after I posted my video, and a lot of people are loving it. So I hope it really works out for you. All right, just a few more minutes and then I will call the poll, although it's really looking like combo two is going to pull through, and there's no way that combo one could win because combo two is at 71%. So I think we could probably just call it. I'm going to end the poll and we'll call it at combo two is the winner. All right. So here's combo two. Those are the colors we're going to be using. And okay. So this pretty sweet stamp set and the dies from Concord and Ninth. There's a definite way that they are expecting you to use them. You make them into an ice cream cone or like a bouquet of flowers, something like that. Well, I don't want to do that. I wanted to do a little bit of my ink painting. That's what I call that technique. Hopefully some of you will know what I'm talking about when I say ink painting, because it's a technique that I have loved to do for such a long time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start out with my Misty, and I'm just going to be stamping a bunch of circles and flowers. I just wanted these really big shapes. I thought those would be a lot of real estate to work with the ink painting. And because I want, well, I am going to die cut them. It won't matter. I was going to say I'm going to use a larger piece of paper and cut it down, but it really doesn't matter because I'm going to be die cutting all of them. So, alrighty. Oh, before I go any further, I have to let you all know who are watching live. There is a giveaway for this live stream today for those who are in the comments. I don't know how I'm going to do this. Why don't you go enter your name on the mail art submission? And you can just, just put like giveaway, 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 giveaway for your whole address. It's fine. Just make sure your email's in there. Okay. This is the giveaway and there's a story with it. So when I was at Simon Says Stamp Create back in April, I was talking with Gina, who is in these live chats quite often. I'm not sure if she's here tonight. I haven't seen her in the chat yet, but, I was talking with her and, I told her that I would send her my set of Caran markers, my old set, because Caran markers sent me a new set that included the neons, but I had still kept using the old set because why not? It's still good to use. So I told her, you know what? I will finally start using the set that they've sent me and I will send you my old set. So I boxed up my old set of markers. I didn't have any packing peanuts or paper to put in to like protect it. So I just threw in a bunch of stamps and dies and paper and who knows what, just a bunch of stuff just to fill in the rest of the box because I had to use the box I had. So I go to the UPS store, I ship it off to Gina, and lo and behold, like 4 weeks later, she emails me and she's like, it never came. I'm like, what? So I followed up and I checked the tracking. It never even left the UPS store. I don't understand what happened and all that. Gabby's asking how to get to the form. Go to the video description down below and there'll be one that says like enter your address for mail art. That's the form I'm going to look at. So for the address, just write giveaway, 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 and then your name and your email. And then I'll know that it's for this one. So package was missing and I was really sad. So I went to the UPS store and thankfully like their default $100 of insurance would basically cover the purchase of a new set of markers. So I emailed Gina and I said, you know what, let's give it a little more time, but if it doesn't work out, I can, you know, get the, and like claim it on the UPS insurance and then order you a new set of markers. She said, that sounds great. So a few weeks go by, sure enough, it is not, like their tracking has no update. So I go to the UPS store. I tell them about it. They're like, okay, we're going to cut you a check, you know, whatever. I'm like, okay. So I go home, I order her new markers, and then I sent her a giveaway package because I felt bad that I had like included all these things in the box and then it never got there. So I think like, oh gosh, it must've been like 2 or 3 weeks ago. She got the packages. She got the new markers that had come straight from Simon Says Stamp, and she got the giveaway package that I sent her. And she said, thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, hi, Gina. Hi, she's in the chat. Yay. So I sent them to her and she's excited. She got them. Well, lo and behold, what shows up on her doorstep this afternoon, or maybe it was this morning, the original box 2.5 months later. I can't believe it. So she asked me what I wanted to have her do with it. And I said, you know what? Let's just draw another winner. And you can send on the original box or whatever. She can pull stuff out if she wants. I don't mind. But we're going to send the original box of the markers on to a new winner. So I'll just draw a winner at the end of this live after, you know, the card's done or whatever. I'll draw a new winner. And then hopefully the winner is okay with it. I'm going to have Gina send the box. So I will have to share your address with Gina, but she's going to send the box on to the winner. So ta-da. Okay, and editing Christine is going to edit all of that out for those who are watching the edited replay. So I'm going to do ink painting, like I said. So ink painting is so fun. I love it so much. We're going to go like this. And I'm actually going to be stamping these quite a few times. So I'm purposely putting them in my Misti like this so I can stamp like this and then I can rotate my cardstock without having to move the stamps and then just, you know, do more. Okay, so here are my color combos. Let's back this out so you can see. And I'm also going to put a little piece of white cardstock behind over here so we can actually see the colors. Okay. All right, so ink painting, this is what we do. Okay, generally for ink painting, you're going to start with your lightest colors. So I'm going to need to start with Tidepool and Honeycomb for sure. So I'm going to start with Honeycomb. And what you do is you're just like, okay, I'm just going to add a little, just going to add a little, few little yellow spots. And then stamp down. All right. Then I'm going to add some Tidepool. I'm not cleaning off the stamp, by the way. Add a little Tidepool. And then same spot. And sometimes where the colors overlap, you're gonna get different colors, which is super fun. All right, I'm gonna move on to Carnation. And I'm also sort of taking note of where I already have color. So it looks like I need to have kind of this color, or maybe, or this kind of side or corner of the circle, and also in the center. I've also got a little bit down in the middle that I could do. Let's do right down the middle like that. And I've got basically like that little corner, and then let's do the top half of that. And these are pretty splotchy because these are brand new stamps. So hopefully I'll get enough ink on here that it'll start filling in. All right, I'm next going to go to Artichoke. And, oh, Rain in the comments. This is Gina M. It's not Gina K, it's a different Gina. But yes, lots of orders from Gina K. Okay, so I'm gonna add a little bit of Artichoke right there. Maybe I'll go right down the center, right there. Okay. Oh, that Artichoke is really dark, isn't it? Probably should have conditioned these stamps before I started in on this. Okay, Fig. Maybe I'll condition them after I'm done here. And then when I do more like stamping on this, because I'm gonna need lots more of these images for my card that I planned, I'll just go ahead and keep stamping. Okay, so there's a little bit of Fig. This is very kind of retro-y. And then we've got a little bit of Peacock. So I'm going to add just a little Peacock right there. Maybe I'll do, then I need to get, and then maybe like right there. All right. So really kind of patchwork looking. This is very interesting. All right, I'm gonna rotate, and then I don't have to move the stamps, but I am going to clean them off. And then the way I'm going to condition them to hopefully get a little bit of a better coating of the ink is I'm just gonna run my fingers over the stamps. I should have done it from the start, but I totally spaced it. All right. And let's, we'll start with the same colors again. I'm gonna do Honeycomb. Maybe we'll do some bigger sections. And we'll do not quite as many colors on every single one. All right, so there's the first one. Let's do a little Carnation. I'm always afraid I'm gonna like break a nail when I open up these ink pads. Okay, we'll do, and then there we go. Sliding those back in that same spot. Let's do a little bit of Tidepool. And right there. All right. Yeah, I like having a little bit larger of the sections showing. Okay, let's do a little bit of the Peacock. In fact, maybe it's just the Fig and the Artichoke that aren't quite fitting in for me. That might be the issue. Okay, a little bit of Peacock. Oh, I love that. That looks great. Okay, so maybe I will, oh, I've got a little bit of the little flower I need to figure out. So I'm gonna do a little more of that Carnation for the flower. Just fix those last little spots that need filling in. There we go, there's the flower. Okay, so that's kind of fun. I like it, so colorful. I love that so much. I do love the Fig. So maybe I'll do some more dots and flowers that have more fig on them. But for now, I really love this color combo over here. Okay, I'm gonna get some more cardstock. I'm not entirely sure how many dots and flowers I need for my card design that I've got in my head, but more than that, I know that for sure. All right, clean those off. And we will start with the honeycomb once again. I'm just gonna super fast. Oh, there we go. All right, I'm gonna add the pink. And maybe I'll do that. Okay. I love to do this particular technique with really solid stamps. So that's what inspired this. Okay, wait, I want this side. I'm gonna clean off that one. Okay. Get that back in the corner. And let's go to fig. We'll just do kind of filling in those last gaps. I love that one up there. That's so fun. Got a little bit of the flower that's not filled in. So let's just add a little bit of the carnation right there. In fact, I might even grab a little bit of the honeycomb and I'm going to add it to the bottom corner flower because there's a lot of blue over here. There we go. Now it looks a little more patchwork. I'm just going to rotate that, clean off my stamps, and do some more. Okay, we're going to do some more yellow. Let's do yellow. I love this orange that came through right there. That's fun. Okay. We'll do a little bit of the blue. Okay. Oh, I love that, how it overlaps and we get that green. Let's do a little pink. Let's do pink right there. Okay, I think this calls for a little bit of peacock. Let's do peacock right there. We'll just do a little bit of blue and then just on that edge. So just little pops of peacock, not like a ton. And then we haven't really done artichoke much, so let's add a little artichoke right there. Finish off that flower. Okay. So I've basically got, four circles and four small circles. I think that might be enough to finish it off, but I'm gonna do one more set just to be sure. Okay. Oh, and Andre has a really good comment. Let me put this on screen. She says, I don't have many ink cubes that would give the hard edges, but I've done this sort of thing with Distress Oxide inks and finger daubers. Good idea. I like that. Okay. Let's continue on. You know, I didn't do pink. Oh, I did do pink in the last one. It was some other ones. Let's do Tidepool first. All right. Add those on. Now let's do a little bit of yellow. I think it really needs yellow to really like show some of the colors. All right. Let's get some pink in here. Let's have it, let's see. Pink right there. Let's do pink. And hold at the bottom. I'm stamping on Nina Classic Crest Solar White 80 pound cardstock. And I'm using Concord and Ninth inks. All right, let's do a little bit of fig and fig right here. Love all that overlapping. Let's do, let's see, we could probably do just a little bit of peacock. So let's see, this flower is not finished and that would be this petal. So I'll put a little, couple little spots of peacock, and then this one needs to go like right there and maybe to finish that spot. Oh, I love that. All right, one more. And I haven't had to move my stamps at all this entire time, which I love. Okay, Tidepool. A lot of Tidepool on these. Big areas of Tidepool. I'm going in with a honeycomb. And let's see here. Let's just have that overlap right there. Okay, do a little carnation, and then I'm like viewing it. I'm like, okay, what's the mirrored side of that? Okay, just a couple little spots that I need to fill in, which I think I'll do with peacock. So I got this little gap right here. You just go like that, and that'll finish it out. And then this side, that'll probably finish that one off too. Perfect. All right, so now I'm going to die cut all of my images that I've stamped. And then I'm gonna arrange them into a pattern on my card. Okay, so here are all of the images that I stamped super fast. And I am gonna be using my, what's the word? Empress Mini. So I'm just gonna cut these down to strips so I can put them through my mini a little bit easier. Because I used 5x7. Cardstock. I should have used just, you know, regular A2, but that's okay. All right, so I've got my images here, and then here are the dies from Concord and Ninth. This is the Pretty Sweet coordinating dies. If I can get it out of the packaging. There we go. Okay, so I've got that circle, and then that one right there, and then the flower, which I've got to figure out which way it, I have to rotate it so that it matches up because it's a little bit of a wonky flower. There we go, that's perfect. These don't have to be exactly right on, but I'm gonna try to get them as close as I can. Then I'll just run this through my die cutting machine. For those of you who are coming in a little bit late, there is a giveaway for those who are watching live. Through an accident of UPS delivery, I have an extra package of Karen markers. They're actually markers that I had been using. And I sent them to someone as a giveaway, and then UPS lost it for 2.5 months. And so I felt so bad. I just ordered her new markers. And then 2.5 months later, here we are. the original package showed up on her doorstep. So she's agreed to send the original package on to a new winner. So all you have to do is go to the link that's down in the video description that says like mail art, like submit your address for mail art. You're going to put your name and your email in and then just put like giveaway, giveaway, giveaway for the address. And then we'll pick a winner. I'm not cutting out the center of the flower. I don't know that they actually even have a circle that would fit. This one might fit, but I'm not going to worry about it. Okay. Moving on. Cutting out more circles and more flowers. And I will pick a winner for the giveaway at the end of this live stream. Okay, is that the one? No. Is that it? No. There we go. This is a really interesting color combo, right? Very different. I'm gonna try to remember how I had that flower dye on so I can get it positioned just right. So I believe it was like this. Oh no. Oh crap. Was it this one? No. I've rotated again. Dang it. It's not even that one either. Seriously, what one is it? It's got to be that one. Yeah, there we go. Get that little circle. And then the big circle. I just love like big polka dots. That's kind of like what I'm going for with this. It's going to create like a big pattern. Oh, thank you, Sophia. That's so sweet. The color of my polish is listed down below in the video description. All right, I'm holding my flower. So hopefully it will be the right orientation. Why does it like not line up? So weird. Okay, there we go. That right there. Run that through. Only one more after this, and then we have all of our dots and flowers. Okay, I'm really testing this. Oh, so they're okay. I didn't really. Oh, that should be the same. Want to bring it over here. Sure enough, it is. Weird. Okay. Circle. And the big circle. I probably was rotating the cardstocks and that was the issue. All right, run that through. Okay, so now I have all these pieces that I'm going to create a background with. I could set my die cutting machine aside, but I am going to put these back on this sheet. I don't really remember where they were, but that works. Okay, so I think I want to do an A2 card. So I'm gonna grab an A2 pre-folded card. I just have a bunch in my bottom drawer. And I'm going to start assembling these in kind of a little patchwork. Well, I guess not really a patchwork, more of just like, kind of like where I want them to be. Hello. could even throw in some dots. I'm creating a pattern. I guess that's not really a pattern. It's not like it repeats or anything. Oh, I'm so glad I stamped and cut a few extra because it looks like I'm going to need them to fill the entire space. Okay. Zoom in a little bit here. Now, I want all of these to kind of stay. Let's see, how do I want to do this? I'm kind of thinking I don't want a white background. I want a colored card base. So maybe I could even have it be like Tidepool or sea glass. I've got these cut ones. I think that'd be really cute. Is that a background? Gray. No, I like sea glass. Sea glass would be really pretty just with all of those on top of it. I also had the thought of using like silver glitter paper or even like a gold pearl. I think silver kind of goes better with this though. They're all kind of cool tones. Like how would it look? Oh no, no, no. I think the glitter's a little too much. But I do like the idea of the sea glass. I think that could be really, really cute. Ooh, a lilac. Like a pale purple. Ooh, that could be really pretty. Ooh, I like that. Powder. Powder's a good one too. I don't know if I had powder in this pre-cut. I'd have to go get a new sheet of it, or even pebble. Pebble would be awesome, but I know I do not have a pre-cut pebble. Let's see here. I think I have like one sheet of pebble left. Okay, I'm gonna grab some powder and pebble. And we'll see how those look. Oh, I love pebble. It's such a good color. Okay. Powder, I think it's just a little too blue for kind of how kind of aqua this is, but pebble would be really pretty. Lilac is really nice too. I almost wish it was like an even more pale purple. I wonder if I have another cardstock from a different company that would be even more pale. I'm gonna check. Let's see. Ooh, no. Concord and Ninth Lilac really is kind of the palest purple I have. Huh. Good to know. Okay. Well, let's do lilac. I almost think it'd be nice to have a little bit of texture on it too. So, like a stripe texture. Let me look through my embossing folders and see if there's one that would work. Because it would need to be really a really simple stripe. Yeah, Spellbinder's corrugated. Love that idea. Hold on 1 minute. I've just got to grab my Spellbinder's Platinum. And we will do a little bit of embossing folder. But you know what, before we get to that, because I don't want to lose this, I'm going to grab some Glad Press and Seal. I think I have it up here in a basket. I could be wrong though. Aha, found the Press and Seal. Oh, it's like a brand new box. Do I have a different box? Hold on. Let me see if I have it elsewhere. Or I guess we'll be opening a brand new Glad present sale. Ha ha! Found it. Okay, so Glad present sale. Thank you, Ken McGuire. So now I can just press this down over my arranged die cuts and then just pick them up all at once. Then I could apply the adhesive on the back and then put it on the purple after I have it embossed. Okay, so here's my Platinum 6 die cutting machine. All right, and here's Spellbinders corrugated. And I'm gonna need to make sure I have this in here like perfectly straight. And if I have my spray bottle, there it is. I'm gonna spray this pretty liberally on both sides. Well, I guess it wasn't that bad. It was just twice. Okay, and then get this lined up just right. I think that's pretty lined up. Close that. And the universal plate system says to use the platform and then the adapter plate, which is not going through. Come on, honey. Hello? There we go. It didn't like me for a minute. Okay. Oh, that's gonna be beautiful. Yeah, it just needed a little something. Okay. Close that up. Alrighty. So while this dries, because, you know, I got it wet a minute ago, I'm going to put some foam adhesive on the back of all of these. Debbie was asking, oh, this is a funny question. Here we go. She says, you were the first person I heard say the Empress isn't great with embossing. Did you find that through trial and error, or do the machine instructions say that too? That was after I broke a 3D embossing folder. And I also realized, like, comparing when I used an embossing folder in the Empress, it always kind of warped the embossing folder, like it bent it. And then when I use the Spellbinders Platinum with their specific sandwich for an embossing folder, it never did that. And I got a much better result with my paper. I always felt like the Empress was just a little too strong, had a little too much pressure, and it ruined the embossing folder and my projects. So, but it's not like that with every single embossing folder. Like the Simons' stamp embossing folders, some of them seem to be okay in the Empress, but specifically with the Spellbinders 3D embossing folders, it didn't do well. So I've just started using the Spellbinders Platinum 6 for all of them. Okay, on to some foam adhesive, and let's see. I'm trying to decide if I'm gonna do just foam tape or if I want to grab some like squares from Simons' stamp, because it might be easier just to grab some squares, but we'll do the foam tape with my big roll. Okay. I'm going to take some scissors and first I'm going to cut this one. Then I've got these other ones. I don't know if I'm gonna need all of these, but I might. So I'm going to try to get as much foam tape as I can covering these. All of these areas, especially the ones on the ends. Like, I don't know what's going to be like hanging over the edge. And I also need to cut some smaller ones for all the little dots. Okay. Just continuing putting foam adhesive down. I'm not sure what's going to be hanging off the edge and what's not. So I'm just kind of assuming everything's going to be adhered. I really feel like for all of these flowers, I need to cut these down and just get like one little piece in each petal. So that's what I'm gonna do. Okay. Also, these little ones can go on the little dots as well. This is so much foam adhesive. I probably could have just as easily just die cut a whole bunch more of each shape and then stacked them. That's totally what Jennifer McGuire would do. She likes to avoid foam tape whenever she can. I just love foam tape. Hi, Sika. All right, Sika, here's some more snip with the scissors. Trying to get small enough ones for the dots. Okay, just a few more. Get these in the petals. Okay, how are we doing on our paper? It's not quite dry, so I'm going to hit it with my heat tool just to speed up the drying. Probably just on low, because it's not like, oh, sorry. It's not super wet, it's just a little bit damp. So I'm just speeding up the drying since I got my cardstock damp before I ran it through my die cutting machine. such a pretty purple shade. Okay, and before I adhere that, I'm also going to adhere my purple to my card base. I'll just use some Tombow Extreme adhesive. And I want to make sure I get a lot of adhesive around each edge of the card and then going that direction, since all of the texture stripes are the opposite direction. And I can just sort of get this in the right spot. I'll probably end up cutting off the sides anyway, because I'm gonna have to cut off the excess dimensional flowers and dots anyway, but I've got a little bit of white right here I want to get rid of too. Okay, so now I'm going to take this and I've got to remove all of the release paper from the foam. And this makes me want to bring in my little trash can. So let's bring in the trash can and make sure we get them in the trash can. Do you guys have a small little tabletop trash can for crafting? Let me know in the comments. Years ago, I used to just accumulate all of my foam tape release papers in like this mug. It was like a really cute mug that Jennifer McGuire had given me years ago. And I just collected them until the mug was completely filled, and then I throw them all out at once. Cheryl, what color are you referring to? The cardstock? The cardstock is lilac from Concord and 9th, if that's what you're asking about. Did I see Callie in here a minute ago? I did. Hi, Callie. Y'all, Callie has been trying out some Dazzle Dried Nail Polish. And she has reported back and said that it's doing great. The real question is, Callie, did you take advantage of the 20% off sale this weekend? I am sad to say that I did. And I have even more coming. I'm watching to see if Callie responds. I don't think she's responded yet. Oh, Callie has a trash can that slides out when she's working. Love it. For those who are just joining for the giveaway, you just need to go enter your name and email address. And you're going to go to the link that's in the video description that says enter your address for mail art or submit your address for mail art. You're going to go there and you're just going to write giveaway, 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 giveaway for the address area. And then I'll know it's for this giveaway. But the giveaway is, hopefully you don't mind, it's my used Karen markers. There's still plenty of ink in them, so there's plenty of use. And then some other goodies that I had included in the box. And they're going to be mailed from my friend Gina in Pennsylvania. Oh, Denise just bought Dazzle Dry. Yay! Oh, Sue has two trash cans. Awesome. Oh, thank you, Andrea, for including that link. Andrea put the link to the mail art address submission form. She put it in the chat so you can see it. Okay, almost there. All right. So now I'm just going to kind of press this down. Get all that foam adhered to my card front, and then I can pick this all up. Oh, yes. Purple was a good choice. And then I can peel off the press and seal. I love that. That is so cute. Now, if you wanted to save the press and seal and reuse it, you could, but I just throw it out. Okay, so now I'm going to turn this back over, and I'm going to use a T-scrub ruler, or you could use any ruler, really, because you're just going to go along the edge here, and a craft knife, and kind of lop off everything that's hanging on the ends. Vicky's on the Dazzle Dry train. Yes. It's so good. Okay, let's do this one first, because I think my ruler is not going to get stuck to the foam tape as much right here. So I'm just going to very lightly run my knife right along this edge. It's going to take multiple cuts to get through everything. But by doing multiple very light cuts, you reduce the chance of the craft knife going crazy and, like, you know, injuring yourself. All right, so on to this next one. Oh, I forgot. There was one side that was a little bit on the white right there. Okay, so this edge, I'm going to have to cut a little bit of the cardstock too. Not a huge deal. Oh, see? That's why you do a light cut. That could have been disastrous. All right, so I'm very lightly cutting through the cardstock. And then it'll eventually get down to the part where I'm cutting through the foam tape. There we go. Now I'm all the way through. Ta-da! Okay, I do have a little bit of this edge that's not quite cut nice, so I'm going to cut from the side. Kind of clean that up a little bit. There we go. Not bad at all. All right, gotta be careful on this one because it's the fold. I don't want to cut into the actual card base itself. So I'm just gonna lightly just trim off the ends. Okay. This one didn't get cut all the way through, but that's okay. We'll deal with that in a minute. I'll just use scissors, which I probably could have done all around anyway, but that's okay. Okay, not bad. I think that looks cute. I like the little bit of texture in the background too. I think that looks really, really cute. All right, for my greeting, I'm going to use this die set from Concord and Ninth. This is the Quintessential Scripty Sayings, and I think I just want to do the hello. Yeah, I just want to do the hello. All right, get this out of the packaging. I'll do this big hello. And then I'll just have it kind of going right across, maybe, yeah, right there at the bottom. I'm thinking just all in white would help it, like, really stand out. So, grab a little bit of white cardstock. Just run that through my Empress. Like, I'm gonna have to cut it at a little bit of a diagonal. There we go. All variety. Oh, I totally did like two pieces of cardstock. Oops. I didn't even notice. Okay, we're going to need a do-over for that. That was user error. Okay, only one piece of cardstock now. Oops. Okay. Oh, yes, much better. Okay. Oh, that's cute. I think I almost want it like, I want it to have a little bit of dimension. This card already has a lot of dimension, but it needs to like have a little shadow or something underneath it. So maybe, I think maybe I'll just die cut another one, but in a different color and have it be offset instead of having it be actually different dimensions. So see, I've got some fig cardstock right here. I could do fig, or I could just go total gray as a shadow. That would totally work too. I think fig would kind of look nice. Kind of emphasize the monochromatic nature of the purple and purple. I think that could totally work. Okay, let's do that. I like that idea. We'll do fig. Oh, hello. We don't need you. There. Run that through again. Oh, hey, Jennifer. All right. Oh, yeah, this is a good choice. And then I can kind of have it offset a little bit. Oh, that's cute. I like that. I like that. That's really cute. All right, let's get my greeting all ready to go and glued. Let's get this one all ready. Hey, with Jennifer and Sika, it's almost like a redo of our live the other day. Okay, do we like it? Is the purple? No, I like it with the white. The white's on top. Okay. Okay, I'm just gonna add just a little bit of glue all over this greeting. This, I love these really large die cut words. Concord and Knight, that does a great job with large die cut words. Yes, Sika, a reunion. All right, so I'm gonna adhere this so that it's just offset a little bit. Okay, and then, speaking of Jennifer McGuire, do a little of that. I feel like it needs glitter or something on it, or maybe glossy accents. Maybe I'll add some glossy accents on this after it's adhered. Okay, that is probably holding it enough. So now I'm going to hold it with my tweezers, and I'm just going to get adhesive on the purple. Now, this isn't going to adhere everywhere underneath the purple. That's why I'm putting adhesive everywhere, because I don't know where it's going to hit those die cuts that are popped up. Like right there. Let's see. Or we could go across. No, nope. We like it like this. Like right there. Put that paperweight on there again. This is a very different card for me. It looks very different from how I envisioned it. I think it's just a color combo I normally wouldn't do, but it works. Kind of fun. Okay. I'm gonna take my scissors and just lop off these extra little tails. All right, and now we have to decide, like, do we want glitter, or not glitter, but glossy accents on this? Or do we want to just keep it as is? I mean, look at this card. It's kind of insane. There's a lot going on. Maybe I don't want to add anything else to it. But I could add, you know what? I kind of do want to add a little glitter. Like, I have this glitter that would look really, really cute. Or maybe I need to walk away. I've got glossy accents, which would be really fun. Just trying to decide. I almost want to cut a purple heart and like put it right there. Jennifer, should I do glossy accents? Or I could do stickles and like kind of smush it around so that it's not like really crazy thick anywhere. Or just leave it. I could also just leave it. It's amazing I did this card in an hour. Let's put it that way. I got Skittles. Oh, kind of. Are you saying it looks like Skittles? Oh, Skills, maybe. Jennifer, how about you add an address to email me and call it a day? You know what? That's not a bad idea. Just call it done. I just feel like I want to add like sparkle or something. You know what? I'm going to leave it. I'm going to leave it as is. We're done. We are done. Let's pick our winner. Well, actually, first I'm going to do the little spiel for those watching the edited replay. And then we will pick our winner. Yay. Okay. Let me zoom in here. So here's the finished card. Lots of dimension happening on this one. There's a lot going on. But in total, I finished this card in an hour, which is kind of amazing. So thanks so much for joining me today. All the supplies, everything I've used, including inks, cardstock, stamps, dies, are listed down in the video description. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time. Okay, let's pick a winner. Got to go over to my web browser here. And let's see here. Mail our address. Okay, lovely. All right. All right, so we just got to pick the ones that came in since we started. So let's see how many there are. Got to get out my keyboard. Hold on. Okay. Okay, there are 242 people who entered the giveaway. 242 going over to random.org. And the winner is number 140, which is the lucky person is Crystal Sylvia. Crystal Sylvia in Rhode Island. Not too far from our friend Gina in Pennsylvania, who's going to mail you your giveaway. So Crystal Sylvia, congrats. I hope you're in the chat and in the comments so we can see your excitement. Crystal with a C, Sylvia. All right, that's the winner. Gina, I will email you her address. She did include her address in her giveaway permission or giveaway submission. So I will just send you her address and you can mail it on over. And Crystal will get the markers and all the other little giveaway items. Thanks for joining me today. If you guys have any questions or anything like that, generally I answer questions at the end of the video after the card is done being made. So if you have any questions and maybe I missed them while, you know, I was working on the card, go ahead and let me know. You can just resubmit the question in the comments here and then I'll see it. Just marking Crystal as the winner. Is Crystal in the chat? I don't even know if she is or not. But Crystal won. I'm not sure if Crystal, I don't think I saw her. Oh, she did. She said, me, yay. Awesome. So glad you were watching. Love it. Awesome. Any other questions? I'm going to scroll up and see if there were any that came in. There were quite a few of you who were watching tonight, so welcome. Let's see here. I don't know if you can see all the texture, but there's that embossing folder texture and then the all of the stamping on the die cuts. Purples and teals, yes. Oh, Sophie says sequin or enamel dots in the flower centers. Yeah, that would be cute. There's really only four shown on the card anyway. All right, I don't see any questions right away. Do you think this technique would look good on folksy cats? Oh, because they are more solid. Yeah, I think you totally could do it. I think it'd be really great. You'd get like a really multicolor sort of stamping. I think that would be beautiful. Let's see here. Folksy cats would be great. Crafty Maker says, what color is your nail polish? This is the color Forbidden Passion. It's actually just a very, very dark red. It's probably more of a fall winter color, but I was just really feeling it when I was doing my nails this weekend. But it's linked down below in the video description if you want to just click on over to Dazzle Dry. What U.S. states have I never visited? Quite a few, actually. I mean, I've been to quite a few, but I've also, I mean, there's 50. So there's a lot. Most of the Western United States I've been to, just because I live out here, so it's a little easier. But as far as the East Coast goes, let's see, where have I been? New York, New Jersey, Ohio, Maryland, Virginia, West Virginia, Florida, Georgia, Tennessee, Ohio, Kentucky. I'm like trying to move west. Okay. Then, let's see. Then we've got Illinois, Wisconsin, Minnesota. I don't think I've been anywhere like Midwest, unless it was like a layover, and I don't count that. I've been to Texas. I've been to New Mexico, Arizona, Nevada, Utah, California, Oregon. I've only been to Washington because I went to Seattle once for about 2 hours when I picked up my cats. So I don't know if I should count that, but, and then, let's see, Idaho, Montana. I'm going to Montana this weekend. That reminds me, my live next week will not be on Monday night. It's going to have to be on Tuesday night. It's a holiday here in Utah on Monday. So Jennifer, question, how much do you miss me? A lot. A lot. But I did see you like just over a month ago. Well, not even a month ago. Like 3 weeks ago, maybe. So that helps. Wait, Vicky says Alexi is in the chat. Is this my niece Lexi? Okay, where? Did I miss it? I don't see it. I'm scrolling back to see. I don't see it. Sorry, Lexi. Say something again so I can say hello. Let's see here. Does your craft mat ever scratch your glass board? Does your craft mat ever scratch your glass board? Do you mean craft knife? No. This glass, like, you can't like cut into it, if that's what you meant. I'm not sure. Let's see. I wasn't ignoring Jennifer. I was just scrolling through the chat. Okay. Let's see here. I'm like not caught up with all the chat because I'm like scrolling back. Taking Lila to bed. Love you. Love you, Jennifer. Good night, Lila. I was like scrolling back trying to find my niece in the chat, but I couldn't find her. But apparently my sister's talking to Vicky on the phone. Vicky, I did not see Lexi in the chat. I'm looking through. I'm like, I know it's not just going to be her name. It'll be her little YouTube channel she's got. So, and I'm scrolling back to see if I can find it, but I'm not seeing it. I know my sister has lots of privacy controls on my niece's YouTube, so it might be that like only certain people can see it, maybe. I'm not seeing it. Of course, I haven't scrolled back all the way. But anyway. All right. She was detrolled. What does that mean? Someone said you were spamming. I'll have to reinstate Lexi. I thought she was a troll and banned her. Oh no. Hold on. let me pull up this live stream and maybe it will pop up. Hold on. Okay. Oh, why isn't, there we go. I have to laugh, Andrea. That was actually a troll. I banned them. She's like, no, that wasn't a troll. That's so funny. Oh, it won't load. Oh crap. I can't go back and see. I don't know how to unblock her now. Oh crap. Okay. Community moderation. I can't see anything on my phone. I think I'd have to go in. Activities with Alexis. Okay, hold on. Maybe I can go to her actual channel and then, okay, how do I unhide user from my channel? There we go. Unhide user. Okay. Okay. Now, Lexi, you can comment. That's too funny. No worries. You probably didn't know what she was saying. I mean, she's, how old is Lexi now? Is she 9? She's only 9. You know what? Now I'm wondering if I went to West Virginia or if it was just Virginia. I have to look this up before I commit to that because I think it's, okay, Colonial Williamsburg is just in Virginia, correct? But I know we drove around while we were there. And we didn't just stay there, so. Now I'm looking on like Google Maps. I'm like, got my phone out, Google mapping it. Yes. It was just Virginia. And I went down to Virginia Beach, but I guess I haven't been to West Virginia. I think I need to go there. Oh, Maria's asking me if I want to go to lunch. She's in Provo. I don't know if I will. I'm shy about meeting people in person. yeah. Okay. Oh, hey, Lexi. Hi, Lexi. What are you doing tonight? I guess you're watching this. Okay, Kelly says, please visit North Carolina. We have the Blue Ridge Parkway in our Appalachian Mountains. We also have the Outer Banks at the coast. Our state is lovely. I used to teach about it when I taught fourth grade. Love it. Crafty Maker says, how many kitties do you have and what are their names? I have two cats. They are Sophie and Daphne. And they are, let's see, how old are they? They are 14 and 16 years old currently. But they will be 15 and 17 at the end of the year. Let's see. Oh, Pam's like, I love when you do 5x7 cards. Would have loved to see the card in a 5x7 before the die cuts were cut off. Yeah, it would look great in a 5x7. I totally agree. What year did I start crafting, or have I always done it since I was a child? Crafting, like this type of crafting, like card making or paper crafting, I started in 2005. So it's been, what, like 18 years? Yeah, 18 years. Whoa, that's crazy. Let's see here. The bottom of coffee mugs? What does that mean? I'm not sure. Oh, the bottom of coffee mugs will scratch your glass mat. Is that what you're referring to? Which color was the Concord & Ninth ink pad? Is it a new color? The colors I used today are these. These are the colors that I used today for the stamping. Will you be doing any Tim Holtz? Make anything with Tim Holtz stuff with his latest Halloween release? I'm not sure. I don't generally have a whole lot of time to do Halloween cards because I do a lot of stuff for Stamptember, and then it's just like right into the holiday stuff, like the Christmas stuff. So if I do any Halloween cards or crafts, it's generally not very many, but I do love Halloween. Halloween has really great imagery. Oh, did I forget to say been to Ohio? No, I think I said Ohio. I said Kentucky and Ohio. Okay. Let's see. Right? This sounds like a great excuse for a big blowout party, Christina's 20th craft anniversary. It's true. So I think this coming up holiday card series, what will it be? I started in 2009. So will this be 14? Wait, 2009, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. And it's 15. It's 15 this year. Sika, really? Your cat's claws scratched your glass mat? Those are some sharp claws. You should clip those. You know what? Now I'm like feeling this. I'm like, do I have any scratches? You know, I do see like a couple little scratches, but they're so minor. I wouldn't even, like, I didn't notice they were there until you guys are pointing them out. I don't know. I've had really good luck with mine. Scrappy Cat has been following me since 2006. Wow. Well, thank you. Do you use Tim Holtz color glazes? You know what? I have them right here. I considered using them. Are you referring to the glaze embossing powder? I have the whole set right here. I haven't had a chance to break them out and use them yet. But I also have this other one from previous colors, the embossing glaze, that I wanted to use. Are these distress embossing glaze? Yeah, embossing glaze, just the packaging's different. See how the packaging's different? Yeah. I really want to do something where they like overlap or something. I think that could be really cool. Oh, fig, that's the color. This is the color you were wondering about, was fig? Yeah, fig's such a good color. Let's see here. Oh, Barbara, I'm so sorry to hear that. Yeah, I want to say they say like the average indoor cat only lives to 13. So like anything past that is just like bonus years, and you just love on them, and just, you know, anything you can get past, it's amazing. Well, leave it to the comments to point out the flaws. Yeah, the flaws in the glass mat. Too funny. All right, well, I'm going to wrap it up here. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. This card, unexpected. I didn't know that this is the way it was going to go, but I really love how it turned out. I think it looks great. Thank you so much for joining me. Like I mentioned, for the edited replay people, I will have all the supplies listed down below. I just have to update it as soon as I'm done here, but I'll update that as soon as I can. And thank you so much for joining me today. I will be back on Wednesday with another video, and then I'll see you guys on Tuesday for a live. So remember, my live time is not this Monday. It'll be next Tuesday. And I will see you then. Thanks so much for joining me, and have a great night.